Hello friends, welcome to our online channel. In previous lecture, we have seen that first introduction part of the CAD/CAM CE. What is the product design concept? What is the product cycle? What is the product cycle with CAD/CAM CE? Its advantages, disadvantages, and some softwares. So in today's lecture, we are going to see the point of functions of graphics software. So in that five functions is there. First is generation of the graphics elements, transformations, display control and windowing functions, segmenting functions and user input functions. So first function, that is the generation of the graphics elements. In this functions, elements consist of certain basic shapes, example 2D point, line, circle, ellipse, parabola, hyperbola, etc., and 3D entity like sphere, cylinder, cone, like this. We are going to create one geometry, whatever that requirement of this element. So by using 2D and 3D command, we are going to create the some primitives or the element of required. So this is the first generation of the graphics element. By using various 2D and 3D command, we are going to create the primitive entities. Next, transformations. It is used to the change model on the display screen and reposition on it the database. If you want to change the model on the display screen or reposition it on the database, so you can use this transformation for different changes. We will see the changes in orientations, size and shape are done with the help of the following transformation types. So if you want to change the orientation of this given element or change the size and shape of, you can change orientation or you can change the size and shape of that entity with various transformation activities. First, there is a translation. You can translate that entity one point to another point. Rotational, you can easily rotate that element at any point. Scaling, you can scale, you can enlarge or reduce that entity. Mirror, you can create the one more object, same object. And shear, you can tilt in any angle with the shear transformation. So this is the second function of the graphics software, that is a transformation. Third, display control and windowing. In that, this function provides the user with the ability to view model from any desired angle and desired magnification. In this function, that computer provides a function to user. User can view that model from any desired angle and magnification. And windowing function provides the user with the facility to choose a coordinate system and define boundary for that picture and head. So in windowing, the computer provides a function to user. The user can choose any coordinate system and define boundary for that same. So this is the display control and windowing function. And next, segmentation and editing. This function provides with user with the capability of selecting, editing, replacing or modifying some portion of that element or model. So by using this four number function, you can easily that system you provide to user, they can easily select, editing, replacing any part, modifying any correction for some portion of that model. Next, user inputs. The interface between users and system through various input devices should be user friendly and graphically in nature. So whatever that user and system is there in between these two, so that nature should be user friendly and graphical nature. We are using various input devices through the system, in that system should be user friendly to the user. The software should provide the flexibility of customization where the user can create his own program as per his requirement. So software should provide some flexibility to suppose a user want to some customize or user wants to some modify in the various tool, or a user want to create new tools in that system. So that should be providing the some flexibility to the user. As per the requirement, user can be modified or customized the system. Okay, so this is the fifth function of the graphics software. So these are the some important functions of the graphics software. Next point, that is a hardware in CAD/CAM CAE. So basically in this system there are two separate divided into two separate part. That is the first one, that is a design workstation. In that design workstation, we are going to provide the two terminals, two points. One is a graphics terminal and second is the input devices. In that graphics terminals, we are going to give some visualization, display screen, input device. We are going to provide some input devices for the inputting the programs. So this is the workstation. In the second side, left side, we can see us take a secondary storage is there for the storing the data, CPU for processing the all process. Last output means we have to display the output from the given the process. So this is the typical configuration of the hardware in the CAD/CAM CAE. Hardware used in CAD system includes design workstation, digital computer, that is a central processing unit, output devices such as plotters, printers, and various secondary storage device. So in that first we will see the design workstation. What is the function of the design workstation? The design workstation consists of the display terminal and a set of the user input devices with which the user interact with geometrical model by entering and numerical data. By using these input devices, we are going to give an input in the form of the geometric data. While entering system command to perform various graphics operations, and by controlling just cursor position of on the display screen. So this is the function of the terminal. So this is the working of the function of the design workstation. Here we can use this, where we are using various input devices for entering the data of the geometric model. And afterwards we have to display that on the display screen with the help of the graphic terminal. Next, the digital computers, that is a CPU. This uses a high speed central processing unit to process a CAD operations. So we have to process, we have to implement that design workstation input data into the CPU. So that purpose we require high speed computers for processing the further CAD operation. Next, output devices. This includes plotters and printers which generates the output from the given CAD system. Whatever that we are given input the CPU in the form of the CAD system processes, that CPU will provide some outputs signals to the output display. So that output device will be generated the output from the given system CPU in the form of the plotters, printers and monitors. Next, secondary storage devices. In this includes various storage devices attached to CAD system to storage programs and data files. The storage medium used can be CD, DVD, external hard devices, pen drive, magnetic storage system, server center point. In this secondary storage, we are going to store the whatever that programs and CAD data files to the secondary storage device. And there are many examples of the hard devices to store this all this data in the form of the CD, DVD, external device, PD. Okay, like this, there are the so many examples of the stored data. So this is the about hardware in CAD/CAM CAE. Next, a graphics workstation. Functions of graphics workstation. First, it must interface with the central processing unit. Whatever that your graphics workstation is there, in that graphics terminal and input devices, that must be integrate with the central processing unit for the further CAD processes. It must generate a steady graphic image for the user. That computer system or graphics workstation, it must be provide some steady graphic image for the further
user information purpose. That should be read, that all the information coming from that graphics workstation. It must provide digital description of the graphic image, whatever that they are going to generate from the data from this input. So that image must have some digital description for that particular image, that must be provided from the graphics workstation. It must translate computer commands into operating functions, and that computer commands, whatever input in the form of the input, that should translate in terms of the operating functions for the further machining operations. It must facilitate communication between the user and the system, and it must provide some facility to communicate between the users and system. Okay, so these are the some important functions of the graphics workstation. Next, components of graphics workstation, that is the first, a graphics terminal and input device. These are the main two components of the graphics workstation. One is given to the output display on the display screen, one is given the input in the form of the various input devices. So next point is image generation computer graphics. So by using CRT, that is a cathode ray tube, we are going to create image generation in computer graphics. So this is the one of the example, best example to create the image generation. In this CRT, we are using phosphorus coating on the screen, CRT screen, and this is the one of the simple example of the image generation in computer system. So we are using this cathode ray tube in the CAD system for displaying any output from the given input and graphics terminal in design workstation. So this is a simple setup, we can easily understand. At the end of the CRT screen, we are using phosphorus coating screen. By using this electron beam, we are imparting on this electron beam on the that screen, and then we will get the some images, whatever you have given input. So next, there are two approaches to generate image on this CRT screen. First is a stroke writing, and second raster scan. These are the simple two approaches. What you want, or how we can generate the image with the help of the stroke writing or raster scan. You can see in the stroke writing, there are zigzag way they are going to that rays, and in raster scan, they are following the simple straight line plan with systematic manner. So that will be create the image on the CRT screen. So there are two approaches, as per your concern you can use any one. Then next are types of graphics terminals. In that graphics terminals, they are divided into three types. One is a directed beam refresh, direct view storage to raster scan, that is a digital TV. So we'll just differentiate these three types graphics terminal in the form of the different parameters. First, image generation techniques. In the direct beam, they are using stroke writing. In DVST, stroke writing. In raster scan, raster scan. So picture quality in direct beam is excellent, DVST excellent, but in raster scan, moderate to good. Data content limited in direct beam refresh, high in DVST, high in raster scan. Selective erase, yes, we can erase selective part in direct beam refresh, no in DVST, yes in raster scan. Gray color, yes in direct beam, no in DVST, yes in raster scan. So color capability, we can change or modify in direct beam refresh, is moderate, no in DVST, yes in raster scan. Animation capability, we can create animation by using this DBR, the direct beam refresh, in DVST, no, and raster scan, we can create animation in moderate. So these are the just differentiate between the just three graphics terminals. Then types of input devices. In this, you can see here, as per the text input, as per the graphics input, as per the direct input devices, there are many examples of the input devices. In that, first text input keyboard. So this is the different example of the input devices: joystick, mouse, trackball, light pane, digitizer, data lodging system. So that type we will start from the keyboard. In that keyboard, it is a primary device used to give input by pressing a set of the keys. In general, keyboard has following keys. First, alphanumeric keys. It includes letters and numbers. Punctuation keys. This includes comma and semicolon, etc. Special keys. These can be function keys, control keys, arrow keys, and caps lock keys. And last, three types of the keyboard. First, original PC keyboard, which is having 84 keys. Advanced technology keyboard, which is having 101 to 104 keys. Multimedia keyboard, which is having 120 to 140 keys. So this is the about keyboard. It is the first input devices. Next, input devices, light pane. By using this light pane, we are going to just input on the data screen. That is the best example of the using the input device. Scanner. Scanning is using for the basic purpose of the scanning the document and store the data into the sort of file. So this is also one of the important input devices for the scanning purpose. In that input devices, joystick. So in that mouse is there. So mouse is basically is a handy device which can be moved on the smooth surface to cause the movement of the cursor on the screen, and it is the pointing devices which is used to input data and information into the computer system. And there are three type of the mouse is there. Mechanical mouse is there, optical mouse is there, wireless mouse is there. So this is about the mouse. Next, trackball. So this is also movable ball mounted on the stationary device which can be rotated manually by using fingers. They are used in playing video games. Trackball is basically used for the video games. Next, joystick. It is a device used for the playing video game as well as used for the controlling the machines such as cranes, trucks, industrial robots. The user moves a spherical ball with the help of the stick in the joystick. So basically joystick and trackball basically used for the video games, and joystick also used for the controlling machine purposes. So these are the input devices to give some input to that computer system. Next, digitizer. In that digitizer, these are the used for the architects, engineers and designers in CAD for designing the purpose such as building, cars, mechanical components and robot. So basically this digitizer is used for the drawing purpose in CAD, engineers some design purpose in architectures, building, designing buildings, car design, mechanical component design, robot design. So by that purpose, engineers and architecture using this digitizer for giving input. So these are these input devices in CAD CAMC system. Next one, that is output devices. So we'll see in output devices, we have already we know in output devices, there are three types is there. In that first is monitors, printers and plotters. So according to the classification, they are just dividing printer in three types: line printer, serial printer, page printer. So there are some type of the printer. We are not going to detail in the printer. We are going to just see as output devices, monitor, printer and plotters. So in that output devices are the hardware which our computer uses to present data to user. In output devices require the information from the computer and translate it from machine language to method that human can understand it, and again it classified into subtype. That is a two subtype is there. First is soft copy output devices and hard copy output devices. So in that first, that is soft copy output devices. The soft copy output devices include all types of the display devices. Display devices are the visual output devices of the computer. The most common type is a monitor. The monitor will display the images or data for the users to observe it before proceeding the hard copy. The different type of the display include CRT,
LCD, LED and projectors. So these are the soft copy output devices. Here we can see display on the projectors, LED, LCD and CRT. By using this display unit, we can easily see the soft copy of the output devices. And next, hard copy. In these devices, we will give to user a hard copy of the what is displayed on the screen. The hard copy can be obtained using printers and plotters. So by using printer and plotters, we can get the hard copy of the output devices. And by using the CRT, LCD, LED and projectors, we will get the soft copy of the output device. So these are the input devices and output devices in CAD/CAM CAE. Next is software configuration. Now this is for only for your information purpose, how we are going to design the software. So this is the model of the graphics software. This is already we have seen that design workstation in that graphics terminal and input devices there. That will be we are converted into or going to connect into the graphics packages, in that there are different CAD/CAM CAE software is there. From that we have to done required operation, then we have to send that program to that our application program, and that will be save some information regarding that part in terms of the software, soft copy, database we are going to create the save the information. So this is the software configuration. Next, history of the CAD/CAM CAE. In 1950 to 60, that MIT, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, produced a simple picture by interfacing CRT and Vivint computer. Just they are just making servo mechanism lab developed and concept of the NC machine on 3-axis they are developed. After that, light pane was developed. Afterwards, APT is developed. 1916-17 between they have started computer to research library. In mid of the 1960, they are starting coming up with the CAD system. Then the designer extend to beyond drafting. In 70 to 80, the golden era of the in computer drafting is come. Came in 1979, IGS also developed. Then National Computer Graphics Association was started. Afterwards, in 1980 and 1990, major research was going on in CAD/CAM. Then integration of the CAD/CAM started, synthetic curve surfaces developed, then different type of the analysis expanded, then hardware software is improved. 2000 in between, reverse engineering is enhanced, cost of hardware software is slowed down, communication medium and networking improved, virtual factory started. After 2000, rapid prototyping and 3D printing started. Then cost of the high performance computer reduced, wireless transmission is developed, and afterwards many advanced computer is entering in the in industry. So these are the some history about the growth of the CAD/CAM CAE. So last point, that is the selection of CAD/CAM CAE software. So how we are going to select the right CAD/CAM CAE system for any critical process? So selection of the right CAD/CAM CAE system is a critical task. So a careful study and evaluation should be done before finalizing the correct software. Some of the major steps and procedure in selection of the CAD/CAM CAE as follows. That is a first committee, evaluation committee. In evaluation committee, comparison of different software with the considering occur, company product take place. Typically the committee could be includes the design, production, industrial engineering and purchase department. So the first committee, evaluation committee, they are going to evaluate the comparison of the between different software, and they are going to commit, so including the design, production, industrial engineering, purchase departments. Likewise, they have to check all these things. Then what do we need, what is the basic need of this software. So we have to give some explanation regarding that. So we have to give some, committee should set up guidelines for the selection of the criteria. They are setting up the some selection criteria for that software, and to evaluate the alternative systems, they are giving some solution. The committee should consider the present and further needs of the requirements while designing the software. So they are going to just asking the question, what is the use of this software in current and future. This is the second step. Third step, a technical evaluation and expert opinion. The committee should
correspond. Technical classification and discussion with the expert and representative of the vendors. So that committee, they are going to just discuss with the vendors and expert, technical expert regarding that the software. Next, who is using it and what to do they say. So who is using and what is the use of that for that particular person and what they are going to say. So technical committee should make the visit and receive feedback from the users of the same software. Those who are using that same software, so committee should visit that user and they have to collect the feedback from that user. And this hands-on report about the software performance from the other user may highlight whole area and problems which are experienced only in day-to-day use. So whatever the user using same software, so committee should have to visit them and receive the some feedback, and according to that feedback they are going to highlight on the area and problems which are experienced day by day, and from that we have to modify or improve that system. Then criteria of checklist. From the various sources, a checklist should be developed based on the list. Suitable, unsuitable software should be eliminated, and the final alternative should they have considered for the further evaluation. So committee should have make one checklist, and from that checklist they have to find out the which is unsuitable software, they have to eliminate, and they have to find alternative for that further evaluation. And last step, that is a cost benefit analysis, that is an important part for the any software. Finally, a cost benefit ratio can be done with finalized the CAD/CAM CAE software. That committee should have decide for final software, CAD/CAM CAE software for the that final procedure. So that will also decide the cost benefit ratio. So these are the some selection procedure for the CAD/CAM CAE software. So our chapter number first is over. So we will see just some objective questions, sample objective questions. Now you can see first is which of the following is input devices: CPU, drum plotter, joystick and monitor. Like this, our answer is joystick. Likewise, there are some sample of this objective question. You just go through it, you will understand how we are going to just make the how we are going to study the first chapter, that is the introduction part of the CAD/CAM CAE. So our chapter number first is over. Thank you so much.